Let's talk to Marie from Orange County, California. Hi, Marie. Welcome to The Narrow Path.
Well, thank you, Steve, for taking my call. I hope this issue is not too trivial.
All right. It deals
with female attire in church, and I'll give you a quick background. We're members of a large evangelical church here in South Orange County. My husband and I have been continually blessed by this church and our church family. But I am flabbergasted by what young women wear to church. And just to present myself, I'm not a prude. I'm not jealous. I have sons, grandsons, daughters, granddaughters. But it is just really shocking to me, and it seems not fair to the wonderful men whom God made to look at that stuff.
I agree.
And here they come to church to try and for 1 hour maybe, or let's say it goes a little longer, an hour and a half, that they don't have to deal with what the world throws at them continuously.
Mm-hmm. I'm completely sympathetic with you. First of all, I don't feel like we can judge those who are outside the church. They're in the darkness. We can't expect them to be making self-effacing sacrifices for the sake of other people's sensitivities because they live for themselves. They're not living for God or for others. And that's how it is. We don't judge those who are outside the church, but we should definitely, Paul said, judge those who are inside the church. Now, I don't say we should judge them harshly. I think it's wrong to judge people harshly, but I think we should make judgment calls about what's right and wrong and then speak the truth in love to those who are apparently not making those judgments very well. Many women seem to be very naive about this. Now, maybe they're not naive. Maybe they know exactly what they're doing. A lot of women say they understand men are very visual, but they act like they're not because they'll dress very provocatively, and then they'll complain when men look at them sexually.
Amen.
And it seems to me like these women don't really understand what it means when it says men are visual. They say they do, but, I mean, we often think we understand something, but till we've gotten in someone else's skin, we may not really know what they're talking about. If a man sees a woman who is showing a lot of her shape and a lot of her skin, something triggers in him that if he's a godly man, he doesn't want that triggered. He wants to keep pure. Now, like you said, you can't expect that the man's going to never see alluring things out in the world. The world's full of temptations. But when he goes into the Christian community, into the church, he should find there people who are striving together with him for holiness and striving to help him in his attempt to be holy as well. I mean, we got such a narcissistic world that people say, well, that's his problem. I can wear what I want. I've got liberty in Christ. You know, if somebody has trouble, that's his problem. Yes, it is his problem, and his problem should be your problem. If one member suffers, all suffer. That's what the Bible says. We're a body here. And if you're giving somebody a problem, it's not a Christian way to think that I have the right to do what I want. Christians, when they come to Christ, they stop thinking about their rights and they start thinking about how can I be a holier person? How can I help other people who are striving just like I am to be holy? How can I avoid putting stumbling blocks in front of them? Now, we have such an immaturity and such a carnality in the church in general that this immodest dress of women is only one small symptom of the bigger problem. The bigger problem is, I think a lot of people there aren't Christians. They're not born again. They don't think like Christians. And if you told them, you know, the way you're dressing, you may not realize this is really making it difficult for the young men, maybe the old men too, to focus on God and to keep their thoughts pure. I think young women in many cases would just say, well, what do I care about that? I have a right to look pretty, don't I? I have a right to dress the way I think looks good. And the very fact that they answer that means they don't know what it means to be saved. They don't know that whatever you do, whatever you eat or drink, whatever you put on, you do all for the glory of God. And when a person is dressing in a way that they have been informed is stumbling other people, and they say, I don't care, then they're not thinking about glorifying God. They're thinking about glorifying themselves. And that's, of course, the opposite of being a Christian. So I think our big problem in the church is not just immodesty of dress. I think the big problem is we've got churches full of people who've never become real Christians and don't even know what it means to be a Christian. They just think they're there to enjoy some music and to get a pep talk that'll help them be a little more spiritual for the next week. They don't think of themselves as part of a body of Christ, a community, servants of everyone else there, laborers together with God for the holiness of the whole group. That's just not the way people think anymore. But I agree with you. I think that they are very wrong. And I think that maybe older women like yourself would be better in the position to voice that to the young women than a man would be. Because if a man brings it up, you know, somehow he's looked at like, you know, he has no right to speak. But an older woman does. But of course, speaking the truth in love is a very important part of that factor. I hope you can do that, because I think the body of Christ needs to hear your voice, Marie. Thank you for calling.